Hey guys, I am Venkat and this is part 28 of Web Development with Blazor video series. In this video, we'll discuss everything you need to know about cells in Blazor DataGrid. Take a look at the data that we have in this employees database table, especially look at this row with employee 82. In the first name and last name columns, we have some HTML, and then in the application, I included this new component, DataGridCells.razor. Within this component, we have this Syncfusion DataGrid, which is binding to the employees database table. And if we take a look at this component in the browser, notice we have the HTML displayed as is. So here's the important point to keep in mind. If you have HTML tags in the data the DataGrid is binding to, then by default, DataGrid displays that HTML as is. If you want the HTML to be processed instead of displaying as it is, then set disable HTML encode equals false on the respective grid column. The default value is true. On this first name grid column, let's set HTML encode disable property to false and on the last name column to true. Remember, the default value is anyway true. Notice the first row in the data grid, Sam's first name is bolded and unaligned. This means the HTML in this column is processed, whereas the HTML in the last name column is displayed as is. Now, here's what we want to be able to do. Apply styles dynamically to DataGrid cells at runtime based on a specific cell value. For example, if the employee first name starts with letter G, then change the cell background color to green. If it starts with letter R, then change the cell background color to red. If it starts with any other letter other than G or R, then change the cell background color to yellow. We can very easily achieve this using query cell info event of the data grid. So first, let's handle the event. For that, we include grid events component, and the type of value our grid is working with is employee, and the event that we want to handle is query cell info. And let's call the event handler query cell info handler. Notice when I hover the mouse over this event, we can see the event handler receives a parameter of type query cell info event args. Notice the name of the event is query cell info and the event argument name is query cell info event args. The only difference is in the argument we have event args word appended. So our obvious next step is to create this event handler method. Let's do that in the code block after this onInitialized method. Private void, the name of the handler, and we know this event handler receives a parameter of type query cell info event args. Our grid is working with employee data. Let's call the parameter args. In the interest of time, let me paste the implementation code here. This is straightforward C# code. First, we are checking if the field that we are dealing with is first name. And this is important because this event query cell info is raised for every cell in the data grid. And we want to process this code only if the field that is being rendered is first name. Hence this first if check here. And then we are checking if the employee first name starts with letter G. If it does, then change the background color to green and font color to white. If it starts with letter R, then change the background color to red and again font color to white. If it starts with any other letter, then change the background color to yellow. There we go. We have the output as expected. At the moment, we are applying styles to a cell. But what if I want to apply styles to the entire row? Again, we want to do that dynamically at runtime based on a specific column value. Well, same idea. The only difference is we handle a different event. To apply styles to a cell, we handle query cell info event. Similarly, to apply styles to a row, we handle row databound event. Query cell info event is triggered for every cell in the data grid. Row databound, on the other hand, is triggered for every row in the data grid. For query cell info event, the event payload is query cell info event args. That is, the event handler method receives a parameter of type query cell info event args. Along the same lines, row databound event handler receives a parameter of type row databound event args. So, in the data grid, instead of handling query cell info event, let's handle row data bound, and let's call the event handler row bound. Our obvious next step is to modify the event handler method, which we have at the bottom right here. First, we want to change the name of the event handler to row bound to keep it meaningful. And we know row data bound event receives a parameter of type row data bound event args. We don't need this if check here. Basically, this is checking if the cell that is being rendered is first name. Remember, row data bound event is triggered for every row and not for every cell. So we don't need this if check anymore. And then we want to apply styles to the entire row, not to individual cell. So args.row.addStyle. Let's do that here and here as well. There we go. We now have styles applied to the entire row instead of individual cells. Now, instead of applying inline styles, we can also apply CSS classes. We have three classes here, green class, red class, and yellow class. And then in the row data bound event handler, instead of using add style method, we use add class. And the parameter to this method is a string array, which means we can specify more than one CSS class. So we are dynamically applying green, red, or yellow class, depending on whether the employee first name starts with letter G, R, or some other letter. And if we take a look at the browser, we have the styles applied the same way as before. Now, take a look at this grid column that is bound to first name field. I've changed the header text to employee first name, and this is a bit longer. If we take a look at the employees database table, again, for this row, I've changed the first name to Presume Technologies, which is obviously a bit longer than these other first names. So if we take a look at this grid in the browser, notice we're not able to see both the header text and first name value. Basically, the width of the column is not enough to display the full value. So what we want to do is turn on text wrap. So for that, on the data grid, we have this property allow text wrap. Let's set that to true. Notice both the header and column content are wrapped as expected. But what if I only want to wrap column content but not the header, or vice versa? Well, for that, we set wrap mode. And to set the wrap mode, we use a different component, and that is grid text wrap settings component. On this, we have wrap mode, and wrap mode can be both content or header. The default is both, which means both the column header and the content are wrapped. If you want only the column content to be wrapped, then select content. Notice now only the column content is wrapped and not the header. We can also show and hide data grid lines. Obviously, we use gridlines property. The value for this property is gridline enum, and it has five options. Default, from the name, you might have already guessed, this is the default option if we do not explicitly specify gridlines property on the data grid. This option displays data grid lines based on the selected theme. Both displays both the horizontal and vertical data grid lines. None, no data grid lines. Horizontal, only horizontal lines. Vertical, you guessed it, only vertical. At the moment, as you can see, on this data grid, we have set grid lines to both. So in the browser, we can see both horizontal and vertical grid lines. At the moment, notice we are not able to fully see this employee first name column header and the content that we have in this first row. One option to fix this is to turn on allow text wrap, which obviously wraps the content. The other option is to use data grid clip mode. So on the data grid, let's set clip mode property. The value for this is clip mode enum. So the first option here, clip, truncates the cell content when it overflows. The second option displays an ellipsis. And the third option, as the name implies, displays an ellipsis with a tooltip. Notice both in the header and the column itself, we have an ellipsis displayed. And when I hover the mouse over, we see the complete content as a tooltip. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.